In the last video about genome annotation, I finished with this question. How can we determine whether an ATG in a genome sequence is really the start codon for an open reading frame that expresses a protein? In this video, I'll talk about different pieces of evidence we can look for to identify open reading frames in a newly sequenced genome. First, most proteins are at least 100 amino acids long. Further, if we assume a random and equal distribution of bases, then the odds of a stop codon appearing in any random 100 codon stretch of a DNA reading frame is over 99%. Therefore, the longer a possible open reading frame extends without a stop codon, the more likely it is that the open reading frame encodes a protein. Second, most amino acids are encoded by more than one codon, and it turns out that not all codons are used with the same frequency in mRNA. Each organism has a codon bias. For example, the amino acid leucine is associated with 6 codons. Study of the H. influenzae genome shows that leucine is coded for almost half the time by TTA, with other codons being used less frequently. In contrast, in humans, CTG is the most common codon for leucine, with TTA ranking 5th out of the 6. CTG is the least used codon for leucine in H. influenzae. So, when looking for open reading frames encoding proteins in a genome, we should consider whether the codon usage reflects the codon bias of the organism, if that is known. Third, for an mRNA to be transcribed, there must be a promoter nearby, and it may be possible to identify elements on the DNA that will regulate transcription initiation. In general, promoters in bacteria are more regular and easier to find than promoters in eukaryotes. Fourth, because of the evolutionary relatedness of different organisms, and because a lot of annotated genomes are available, for a genuine protein encoding open reading frame, it is usually possible to identify similar genes in other organisms. Software such as BLAST exists that allows you to compare a possible gene or protein sequence with nucleotide or amino acid sequences of known genes or proteins in other organisms. The program will look for similarities and report back with the highest matches it finds. For example, here, a query protein sequence has been matched with a particular protein found in a database. The yellow highlighting indicates residues that are identical or have similar chemical properties in the two sequences, while the green highlighting indicates residues that are dissimilar. In this example, 68% of the residues are identical and 82% are similar. The expectation value gives an estimate of the likelihood that a match this good will occur by chance. The lower the number, the less likely that the two sequences are actually unrelated. The expectation value here, 10 to the power of minus 111, is very low indeed. It's also possible to align many sequences at the same time and look for patterns in different organisms. Organisms that are closely related through evolution should show more similarities in their protein sequences than more distantly related organisms. Parts of the protein that are particularly important for function should be conserved in different organisms. So if we can find similarities between our suspected open reading frame and genes or proteins that are known to be expressed in other organisms, that is evidence that our open reading frame really does encode an expressed protein. Fifth, if an open reading frame encodes a protein, we should be able to detect the presence of the transcribed mRNA in the organism. Note that the mRNA might be expressed only under certain conditions or only in certain cell types of a multicellular organism. I described several ways to look for the presence of a particular mRNA in previous videos for this course. And sixth, if an open reading frame encodes a protein, we should be able to detect that protein in the organism. Again, the protein may be present only under certain conditions or in certain cell types. Most commonly, one would analyze protein fragments from the organism by mass spectrometry to look for the protein. The field of proteomics consists of many advanced separation and analysis techniques designed to catalog and quantify individual proteins in complex mixtures. Keep in mind that full genome annotation involves looking for other important sequences, not just protein encoding open reading frames. For every genome, annotation is an ongoing process, as researchers discover more and more about the organism. Every bit of information adds to our understanding of how organisms function at the molecular level. The availability of annotated genomes for thousands of organisms has given us tremendous insights into how life works, but there is much more that we still do not understand. So it is a great time to pursue studies in biochemistry and molecular biology.